Streaming from your Nintendo Switch to your PC is easy once you know how. So today I'm going to break down everything you need to know about connecting your Nintendo Switch to your PC so that you're able to stream. If you like today's tutorial, make sure to like and subscribe so you can keep coming back for more helpful content. So what do you need to get started? Well, first, and maybe most importantly, you need a Nintendo Switch that is dockable. So the original console or the Nintendo Switch OLED will work perfectly fine, but unfortunately the Nintendo Switch Lite doesn't have the capability to output video and audio, so unfortunately you can't use that console for streaming. It's just one of the trade-offs of getting your hands on a cheaper console. You'll also need the Switch dock, a power cable, and a Nintendo Switch Pro controller, or detach the Joy-Cons. Obviously you'll need a computer, but this is where a two monitor setup is going to be a lifesaver. As you'll be using your primary monitor as a gaming display, a second screen will allow you to monitor your streaming software and other windows like chat. The one piece of the puzzle that you might be missing is a capture card. A capture card will be able to split the output from your Nintendo Switch so that you'll be able to display your gameplay on your monitor and also capture gameplay for your stream through your PC. There are a range of capture cards out there, from ones that you install internally in your PC to ones that you connect externally through USB. I personally use the Elgato HD60S external capture card. It retails for around $300 Australian. Capture cards can get pricey, like this Rode Streamer X with its own audio interface controls, but you can get some really highly reviewed capture cards on Amazon for under $50. Finally, you'll need to check if your capture card comes with a HDMI cable. You'll need two HDMI cables for an external capture card. Now that we've got the hardware out of the way, here's how you set it up. First, set up your Nintendo Switch dock so it's connected to power. Next, connect your first HDMI cable to the dock's output and plug the other end in the capture card where it says in. If you have two monitors, take out your second HDMI cable and plug it into the output on your capture card, and plug the other end into your monitor. To be able to capture the gameplay for your stream, you'll need to use the USB cable that comes with the capture card and plug it into your PC. Most external capture cards will be powered by your PC through this USB cable, but check if your capture card needs external power and make sure to plug that in too. Finally, don't forget to dock your Switch. Now that's all set up, we can head over to the streaming software. When you go to add a video capture device, you should see your capture card as an input option. Some capture cards will only turn on when the device it's connected to is powered on, so if you don't see it, make sure to power on your Switch in the dock. You can leave the capture card to default settings, but feel free to play around with these if you like. If you want to be able to hear your gameplay and stream your gameplay sound without delay, you might need to change a couple of audio settings. Here's how I have mine set up. Still in this property screen, make sure the audio output mode is set to capture audio only and uncheck use custom audio device. Back in the main screen, go to advanced audio properties for the capture card and change the audio monitoring option to monitor only. This means audio is going to you, but not out to the stream yet. So you'll also need to make sure you have desktop audio added as an audio source. To do that, go to File, Settings, Audio, and make sure desktop audio is set to default. In advanced properties, your desktop audio should be set to monitoring off. With this setup, it means you are hearing your gameplay directly, and OBS is capturing that gameplay sound and everything else generated by your computer, like alerts, and outputting that all to your stream via the desktop audio channel. I find audio mixing is one of the hardest things to wrap your head around when you first start streaming. I use the method that I just showed because it keeps my audio mixer tidy, and it makes it easy for me to go from streaming and gaming on my Nintendo Switch to streaming and gaming on my PC. You'll probably find your own best practice for audio mixing as you get more into streaming, but just remember, if it works for you, there's no wrong way to audio mix in OBS. And now you're all set up to stream your Switch gameplay. I could do a whole bunch more content on how to set up your OBS and your alerts, etc. If you're interested in seeing any of that kind of content, let me know in the comments below.